So, Dr. Elliott, could you show me or demonstrate how one of these Ferticare devices works?
Sure. I'll show you. This is the Danish Ferticare. And what it is, it's developed for people with poor hand function so that they can just hit it and it turns on.
Oh, okay. Okay.
However, you'd still need to adjust this here, which is your the millimeters that it will go up and down. This is the thing that goes up and down.
Okay.
So the speed you can adjust here, okay, and then your amplitude you can adjust here. So it was designed for people with poor hand function, but it's not perfect. So
right.
Some people have a harder time with this than usual. This is a little knob that comes off and that you can put in proper solutions for cleaning. So this is why this is so expensive, because it's adjustable. The benefit of this is that somebody might not work on a lower one. They can adjust it till they eventually can work on a proper speed and amplitude. Whereas other commercial vibrators like these are way cheaper. This is like $40 Canadian, but it's not nearly as strong as this. So one of the things we do at our clinic is we hotwire this. And other patients have hotwired. They crack open the casing here, and they jack it up so that this becomes stronger. And if you listen to this one, it's quite a bit stronger.
Oh, my God. Okay.
So not very sexy. But,
right. Okay.
However, that said, some patients work to this. Some patients work to this. Some patients work to Hitachis that they found, thumpers that they found.
Okay.
But usually they're too slow. You need to have something that will go quite quickly.
Okay.
So if you are prone to dysreflexic, you can imagine putting one of these on is going to shoot your blood pressure up. So that's why it's better to test it on and off, on and off, and see how you're doing in terms of symptoms, knowing that your symptoms don't correlate with your blood pressure, that you could have no symptoms at all and still have a high blood pressure. So to be careful.
Right. So would you recommend these patients then to be checking their blood pressure at home at the same time as using these?
I mean,
that
would be ideal, is to get a home blood pressure cuff and see. I mean, before injury, your blood pressure would go 170, 180 at ejaculation systolic. That's normal.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. When you're 60 or 70 years old, it's probably 150, 160. It dampens a little bit. But when you're young, you can handle these swings.
Right, right.
What we are concerned about is blood pressure over 200, 250, that can suddenly go to 300, okay? And the little blood pressure cuffs that you can buy at home, they're better than nothing, but they're not as accurate as our academic machines that we use in research. And they're very sensitive, and they show really how high you go.
You mentioned cost difference. How much does this Ferticare cost?
So I think right now it's on the web for $600 US,
okay,
I think.
So it's quite expensive.
It's quite expensive, but it's the only product out there. But to be honest, a lot of people try other vibrators and try manipulating them to make it work.
Okay. I'm concerned about my patient who's the C5 quadriplegic I mentioned. I don't think he really has good enough hand function probably to adjust the knobs and the settings. So what would you recommend that he use?
Well, I'm a real believer that caretakers can set you up to be sexual. They can make sure your bladder is emptied. They can, put a vibrator on the side. Nothing sexual, but just set you up so that you are able to use things. You can also get occupational therapists involved, where they can have cranks that all you need to do is bend it down.
Okay.
So there's lots of ways that you could figure out how to get this done.
How would a new patient, for instance, going back to my patient who's a new C5 quadriplegic, how would he go about finding a caretaker and sort of advertising the fact that he might need some assistance? I think he would probably feel very uncomfortable advertising that and not being sure how to go about that.
Yeah, I wouldn't phrase it that I need help ejaculating.
Okay.
I would phrase it that you need assistance with bladder and bowel issues, which is fine. That's part of what they're trained to do. But I think when you're interviewing a caretaker, you have to say, look, I'm still a sexual person, and I need some help setting up my sexual environment. But make it very clear that you're not expecting them to do anything sexual.
Mm-hmm.
So you're not expecting them to put the vibrator on or this or that. because that's going to go against their personal feelings or their code of ethics or whatever. We have some guidelines now around asking caretakers to respect the sexuality portion just as they do the bladder and bowel.